start with the big story playing out in the state of Tamil Nadu, which is over the festival Jallikattu, as protests have now reached the streets.
Yes, essentially spearheaded by the main opposition in the state, the DMK, which is holding massive statewide protests there. More specifically speaking, also outside the collector's office in Chennai. And they're demanding an ordinance by the centre, a clear sign for the centre to step in to lift the ban on Jallikattu.
Well, they accuse the centre of being anti-Tamil and disrespecting their age-old traditions. That's the opposition party. Meanwhile, the ruling regime, Panneerselvam Chief Minister, has also reaffirmed the resolve of his government to conduct Jallikattu, saying they will not be backing off.
இந்த விதத்திலையும் வந்து ஒரு அரசியலோ இல்ல இது வேற எதுவுமே கிடையாது. இது வந்து நம்மளுடைய கலாச்சாரம், எங்களுக்கு இந்த ஒரு விஷயம் வேணும்ன்றதுக்காக நம்ம எல்லாருமே குரல் கொடுத்துருக்கோம். இன்னைக்கு நல்லபடியா அது நடந்திருக்கு அப்படின்றதுல சந்தோஷமா இருக்கு. பாட்டுக்காகவே கைது பண்றேன்றாங்க, மாட்டுக்காக என் நாட்டுக்காக கைதாக மாட்டேன்றாங்க. அது வந்து பிரச்சனை இல்ல, கைது ஆகுறத பத்தி எல்லாம் பிரச்சனை கிடையாது. பட் என்ன சொல்ல வரேன்னா, அந்த மாதிரியான ஒரு தேவை இருந்தால் பண்ணலாம்.
Our government has now removed that geo and superseded it with a new geo, and according to that the Jallikattu can be allowed, and I would expect the Supreme Court will, with some severe conditions on maintaining decency and animal preventing animal cruelty, they will allow it. But you have to wait for it. Now they say, no, Jallikattu is coming on 14th, so what, you have it next year. What is the, this is a permanent festival. If the Supreme Court grants it, if the Supreme Court does not agree, then we can bring an ordinance.
The Supreme Court, in its wisdom, three times has ruled that you cannot have Jallikattu at all without harming animals, without harming people, without harming society as a whole. It is an undesirable practice. It is, you cannot defend alcoholism, vandalism.
Organized by social activists, by activists who argue for Jallikattu, there is no other protest planned by any other political party for today. Mostly it is the protest by social activists and also by activists who argue for Jallikattu. This has been a very emotive issue for the people of Tamils. They say that successive state governments as well as the central governments have failed to understand and respect the sentiments of Tamils. They argue that Jallikattu is an ancient traditional sport that has its roots in Sangam literature, and the successive state governments have only tried to hijack this issue for their own political mileage, but right. They have done very little for the cause of the bull taming festival.
It's interesting, Lokpriya, we see how they continue to try and build pressure on the central government over this particular issue, realizing that even though the Supreme Court has passed this verdict in 2014, once again in 2016 on the matter, despite of knowing this, they continue to just do this for appeasement politics in the state.
Definitely, yes. The Supreme Court has come down very clearly stating the reasons why it has banned the annual bull taming sport. It reasons that it is the most cruel cruelty to the animals, and also the fact that human beings are endangered in this particular sport, and that is the reason why they are banning this particular festival. But what political parties say here is that the Supreme Court is not realizing the culture and tradition that is associated with this particular sport, and arch rival DMK is blaming the AIDMK for not arguing the case in an efficient manner in the Supreme Court, for not arguing in terms of culture, in terms of why it is important to the sentiments of Tamil people. Even as the central government is resisting to revoke the ban and promulgate an ordinance, blame game has reached a feverish pitch in Tamil Nadu. DMK and the AIDMK are blaming each other for the present state. Meanwhile, the people of Tamil Nadu still hope that an ordinance might be promulgated, because there is still 24 hours to go for the Pongal festival, and there is a hope on ground, but it remains to be seen if the central government will do that or not.
But otherwise, with respect to the celebrations there, have there been certain areas where Jallikattu has gone ahead with irrespective of what's been decided there?
Well, Jallikattu is part of a three-day Pongal festival that is celebrated across Tamil Nadu, and Jallikattu takes place in the southern region of Tamil Nadu. Alanganallur is the epicenter of Jallikattu, and it takes place on the second day of Pongal, which is known as Matu Pongal, a day where the farmers celebrate and thank the cow for their farming activities. So that is the day when Jallikattu takes place. Already we saw in Cuddalore yesterday, there was a group of people who defied the ban and tried to conduct Jallikattu, but the police detained them and prevented that. So we have to wait and see whether villagers will defy the ban and whether they will conduct that festival. And that will be known only on Sunday.
Okay, that will be known only on Sunday. But Lokpriya, about the situation on ground in terms of preparations, because this festival would require preparations, are we looking at the police being a little proactive or lackadaisical in their approach? Because if local organizations were to perform in certain parts, Jallikattu, would the police crack down? Because if they did, this would be in contempt of court after all. So how is the police actively really going about this?
Definitely, yes. The police have a big role to play in this. In Alanganallur especially, where the mecca of Jallikattu, the police have ensured that the bulls are come out and the bulls are not let loose. So the police have taken down the phone numbers of every bull owner and have given them strict warning, saying that strict action will be taken if the bulls are let loose. So definitely the police are being proactive in terms of ensuring that the villagers do not defy the ban. This is up till now. What happens on Sunday, we have to see, because Tamil Nadu Chief Minister O. Panneerselvam very clearly in a statement had said that his government will ensure that Jallikattu will take place and that they will not give up this right of Tamils. But what does that translate on ground? Mm-hmm. If come Sunday, if villagers are going to conduct Jallikattu, if they are going to participate, then what will be the role of the police? Will they just be mute mm-hmm. spectators, or will they crack down on the people? So all this the police as well as the state government is in bit of a pickle. We need to see on Sunday whether Jallikattu will take place or not.
Mm-hmm. Stay on with us, Lokpriya. We've gotten multiple reactions here on this. Those including animal rights activists, of course, who've been in favor of that ban. We're going to take a listen into those.
कुछ दिनों से जल्लीकट्टू के मामले में की जा रही मिसरिपोर्टिंग का संज्ञान लेते हुए आज सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने तमिलनाडु के कुछ ऐसे लॉयर्स जो जल्लीकट्टू के लिए लड़ रहे हैं उनको रेप्रिमांड करते हुए कहा है कि मिसरिपोर्टिंग नहीं की जानी चाहिए और सुप्रीम कोर्ट इस मामले में अपना आखिरी फैसला खुद के समय में अपने निर्धारित समय पर बताएगी और इसके ऊपर कोई भी मिस रिपोर्टिंग या किसी प्रकार की अननेसेसरी कवरेज ऐसे जल्लीकट्टू के लॉयर्स को नहीं लेनी चाहिए.
Taking cognizance of the Supreme Court decided way back about something, it had seen certain merit in banning it. I think it's time for us as society, as people, to look at certain traditions which are in violation of certain other principles. I think if that kind of maturity we are not able to develop, it just speaks very badly about where have we reached.
It's linked with the peasant's life and their culture. The Pongal celebration itself is a harvest festival. Those who toiled long, and when they see the results and yields, they celebrate it by commonly all the people joining together and celebrate it about the harvest. It is very, very natural. It's nothing new to or special to Tamil Nadu.
Masle ka hal dhoondne ki bajaye, president rule lagane se kya masla hal ho jayega? Main ye samajhta hoon ki Subramanian Swami saab ko is tarah ke bayanat dene ka jo shauk hai, उसको आप बंद कर देना चाहिए. उनकी उम्र अब इस तरह के बयान देने की नहीं रही.
Sometimes when the courts take a decision, it's a far-reaching decision. It advances our way of thinking very rapidly. But ordinary people take time to understand that. So I think the duty really is on social leaders and political leaders to explain that in the overall context, this is not a bad thing. But how do you do this, in how much time you're going to change attitudes, etc., it's not an easy job. And I think that one must appreciate that there will be a lot of political pressure and a huge responsibility on local leaders to find a solution.
मैं मानता हूं कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट का जिस तरह से जो जानवर है उसको उसके साथ उसको तंग करके जो खेल खेला जाए वो कैसे मानवीय हो सकता है इसलिए सुप्रीम कोर्ट का जो फैसला उसको बरकरार रखना चाहिए
मैं समझता हूं कि जाहिर है कि कोर्ट सर्वोपरि हमारे देश में जो सर्वोच्च न्यायालय है उसका जो भी फैसला है जो भी निर्णय है वो हम सब पर लागू होता है पूरे देश पे लागू होता है तो इसलिए जब तक वो अपना फैसला नहीं बदल देती है तब तक के राज्य सरकार हो या कोई राजनीतिक दल हो उसको ये अधिकार नहीं है कि उस फैसले के विपरीत जाकर उसका आयोजन करें
श्री सुब्रमण्यम स्वामी के वक्तव्य की मैं आलोचना करता हूं ये आर्टिकल 356 का दुरुपयोग है और मैं भारतीय जनता पार्टी के नेताओं से चाहूंगा कि इस तरह के अनर्गल वक्तव्य देने से वो डॉक्टर स्वामी को रोकें इससे केंद्र राज्य संबंध खराब होंगे
दिस मस्ट बी अंडरस्टूड प्रॉपर्ली एंड गवर्नमेंट विल हैव टू डू समथिंग गवर्नमेंट विल हैव टू गो फॉर स्पीडी अपील फॉर अ रिव्यू ऑफ जुडिशियल वर्डिक्ट गिवन टुडे एंड सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट मस्ट वर्क टुगेदर to see that Jallikattu is allowed in the state of Tamil Nadu.
Jallikattu events, bulls are poked with sticks, they're jabbed with knives, they're made to drink alcohol there, their eyes are rubbed with the tobacco and chili pepper. So looking at all this evidence in 2014, the Honorable Supreme Court of India, the learned judges banned this particular game. And we are very hopeful that the government of India will not backtrack, will not turn the clock back, and allow such cruel events because they are a blot on the nation.
All right, let's go back to our colleague Lokpriya, who's been getting us further details of the opposition protests over there. Just one more day to go for the festival of Jallikattu. We were asking you about the preparedness of the police as well. You're saying that precaution has been taken, but despite all of that, we're looking at the political pressure that continues to mount. Tell us about the letters, Lokpriya. DMK, of course, having their set of protests, but AIADMK. Sasikala has written a letter. Panneerselvam has written a letter. What's happening on that front? Has the PMO taken cognizance of any of this? Any response coming in at all?
AIADMK General Secretary Sashikala has written to the Prime Minister on this particular issue, and we also saw Tamil Nadu Chief Minister O. Panneerselvam writing this letter. So time and again requests have been made to the central government asking them to promulgate an ordinance. So definitely the pressure is mounted by the ruling government over here. But will the central government heed to that? That remains a million dollar question, because when the central government tried to revoke the ban last year on the 7th of January, after the Supreme Court struck down this particular issue, the central government was heavily criticized by the state Supreme Court for overriding the judicial power. The Supreme Court gave a earful to the central government. So ever since that, central government has maintained a cautious distance on this particular issue, and they continue to maintain that they are all for this sport, but it is due to the legal hurdles that the sport cannot be conducted. So that is being very diplomatic on part of the central government. Mm-hmm. And there is very little hope really for the central government to promulgate an ordinance, because if they do so, definitely they will be inviting the court's wrath. Whether they are going to risk that is something we have to wait and see.
Lokpriya, help us understand, what are your sources telling you on ground with respect to the assurances here that have already come in from Chief Minister Panneerselvam that they're going to go ahead with the sport Jallikattu as a major part of the Pongal celebrations on ground? Are preparations taking place already along those lines?
Well, Well, as I said earlier, there are not much of preparations that are taking place for Jallikattu. The police have warned of strict action against those people who indulge in this bull taming sport. But whether they are going to defy the ban and conduct is something that we will come to know only on Sunday. But as of now, the villagers are still trying to persuade the various government organizations in allowing them to do Jallikattu, in allowing them to conduct this annual bull taming festival. But they are protesting across southern parts of Tamil Nadu. As of now, it is a protest mode for the villagers, trying to reason with the governments on the need to conduct Jallikattu. But they have not defied the ban as of yet. So whether that will happen is something we have to see on Sunday, the second day of Pongal, when Jallikattu takes place.
That's right. With reports, they're already suggesting, though, that areas such as Madurai and Trichy there are already ready to host this festival. A certain amount of preparation there that has already gone on ground to go ahead with that sport. Eventually, if it, of course, takes place, one would need to see tomorrow. But officially speaking, Lokpriya, this is already a statement that is coming from the Tamil Nadu government that they would be going ahead. And that in itself could be seen as contempt of court.
Well, definitely, yes, that is what has led to so much of confusion on the ground, because Tamil Nadu Chief Minister Panneerselvam in a statement very clearly said that his government will ensure all that it can for the conduct of Jallikattu. He said this on Thursday, on Wednesday, and then on Thursday evening he again goes and gives a statement to the media where he says that his government expected a good news from the Supreme Court, but that was not the case. So the flip-flop by the state government on this particular issue has created confusion on the ground. So if the villagers are going to defy the ban and conduct Jallikattu, what will be the role of the police? Will they be mute spectators or will they take action? Because if the villagers are going to defy the ban, that will invite strict action. And we are talking about farmers over here, because they are the ones who participate in this festival. So will these people defy the ban, conduct Jallikattu, invite the court's wrath, or will the state government protect them? All this is something we have to wait and watch.
Yes, but also there is criticism coming in from other opposition parties like the central BJP. We're looking at many leaders who say that their president's rule should be imposed, because there is, of course, violation of Supreme Court's rules over there. But I'll just come back to you for that, Lokpriya. There are some reactions coming in. We'll take a listen in first.
State government ka, sabhi government sarkaron ka ye farz hai ke jo Supreme Court ne kanun declare kiya hai, uski manna na ki jaye. Unko kanun enforce karna padega, aur agar enforce nahi karenge, to iska matlab ye hai ki constitutional breakdown ho gaya. तो मैं ये समझता हूं कि रिस्पांसिबल स्टेट गवर्नमेंट है और वो ऐसा काम नहीं करेंगे.
We expect that both the central government and state government will raise to the occasion and see to it that the ban is lifted by passing an ordinance. This can happen any time. They have the power in their hands, and nothing can stand in the way of the central government. If at all they could pass an ordinance, realizing the sentiments of our Tamil people, and we request on behalf of, we have seen the people who have gathered there and their feelings and all that. So I request on behalf of the Tamil people and DMK that the central government will pass an ordinance at the earliest possible.
நம்பிக்கையோடு இருந்தோம், இந்த மாதிரி நம்மளுக்கு சாதகமான பதில் வந்து சேரவில்லை. நம்பிக்கையோடு இருந்தோம், இந்த மாதிரி நம்மளுக்கு சாதகமான பதில் வந்து சேரவில்லை.
எந்த விதத்திலையும் வந்து ஒரு அரசியலோ இல்ல இது வேற எதுவுமே கிடையாது. இது வந்து நம்மளுடைய கலாச்சாரம், எங்களுக்கு இந்த ஒரு விஷயம் வேணும்ன்றதுக்காக நம்ம எல்லாருமே குரல் கொடுத்துருக்கோம். இன்னைக்கு நல்லபடியா அது நடந்திருக்கு அப்படின்றதுல சந்தோஷமா இருக்கு. பாட்டுக்காகவே கைது பண்றேன்றாங்க, மாட்டுக்காக நாட்டுக்காக கைதாக மாட்டேன். அது வந்து பிரச்சனை இல்ல, கைது ஆகிறத பத்தி எல்லாம் பிரச்சனை கிடையாது. பட் என்ன சொல்ல வரேன்னா, அந்த மாதிரியான ஒரு தேவை இருந்தால் பண்ணலாம்.
Let's go back to our colleague Lokpriya. Lokpriya, as I was asking you a couple of moments ago, the fact that these political parties in Tamil Nadu are saying that they will anyways go ahead with Jallikattu, there is a lot of criticism that's coming in from the other national opposition parties who say that such sort of you know, pressure being mounted, and the fact they want to go ahead with the Jallikattu festival could also seek president's rule, because this will be violation of the Supreme Court's orders.
Well, none of the political parties in Tamil Nadu say that they will go ahead and conduct Jallikattu. They are only stating that if the villagers defy the ban, then we will support them. It is not a blanket statement coming from political parties saying that they will go ahead with Jallikattu. They are only saying that if villagers conduct, then they will support it 100%. We have to look at this in a political angle. For the BJP, they do not have much of a stake in Tamil Nadu, and this is largely seen as affecting their interest. The state BJP also is in a very troubled waters on this particular issue, because it was the inconsistent statements given by Pon Radhakrishnan, state minister from Tamil Nadu, a union minister of the BJP, who had given inconsistent statements on Jallikattu that created a lot of confusion and that created a lot of bad goodwill for the BJP, because then also was the issue of the restricted holiday for Pongal. So all this coupled together, it gave an appearance that the central government is being unkind to the people of Tamil Nadu. That is the sentiment, that is the mood of the people here, and political parties are only trying to cash in on that and trying to mount pressure
of attacking the state government on this.
At the end of the day,
Lokpriya, if you got that question, how many political
government? Because at the end of the day, it is.
Please go ahead.
Well, the political parties over here in Tamil Nadu are attacking the central government, because at the end of the day, it is the central government that has the power to promulgate an ordinance, and it is under their mercy whether this festival will take place or not. This is as far as attack on the central government. When you look at the opposition parties, they are attacking the ruling AIDMK government, because principal opposition DMK says that till they were in power, there were rules and regulations in place to check cruelty for animals, and it was only due to the lapses in these rules and regulations the Supreme Court came down very heavily. So the DMK says it is the inefficiency of the AIDMK that we are in this particular situation. They did not handle this issue in a proper manner. They were very careless on this entire issue. They did not argue in the court in terms of culture and tradition. They did not elaborate on how Jallikattu is an intrinsic part of Tamil tradition and culture.
Okay.
And that is the reason why the Supreme Court had banned the issue. So even as the central government is refusing to revoke the ban, blame game continues here for the political parties.
Okay, Lokpriya, stay with us, because on our screens we are tracking latest visuals that are coming in of the protests of the DMK parties. We can see now these full screen images of how the protest has begun. Stalin himself had launched a protest on the location where Lokpriya is reporting at this point of time. Large number of people of the DMK on the streets now. This is a statewide one-day protest in support of the festival of Jallikattu, urging the central government to pass an ordinance on this festival so that they can go ahead with the celebrations over the weekend. We're looking at how people have now hit the streets, but of course the ruling party of Tamil Nadu has been writing to the Prime Minister time and again. Interesting to note how Sasikala actually invoked the former Chief Minister Jayalalitha over here, saying that she also wanted to see Jallikattu being performed in Tamil Nadu, and she's only taking forward that wish of the former Chief Minister Jayalalitha. That was the reason why she decided to even write the Prime Minister, keeping in mind, of course, the sentiments, the culture, the tradition of the people in Tamil Nadu. But these are latest inputs of that statewide protest of the DMK coming to us.
Yes, it's the protests that are statewide this year around, of course, have been far stronger than what we've seen in the past 2 years. And a lot of the areas already showing preparations on ground to be ready to go ahead with the sport tomorrow, because they've been arguing it has been 2 years ever since the ban was brought into place in the year 2014. It has been 2 years that Jallikattu has not been allowed to go ahead with, and this year around they would be going ahead.
That's right. We'll leave it at that for a moment. Lokpriya, thanks very much for joining us for the moment. We'll take